The generation that witnessed the independence movements across Africa in the 1960s, Kenneth Kaunda, can only be described as a political colossus. He has died today after 97 years of what is no doubt a fully lived life. His seat in a room that has the likes of Nelson Mandela can surely not be disputed. Let's have the details in this report.
Kenneth Kaunda was one of the pioneer leaders of a new Africa as countries threw away colonialism in favor of independent statehood. A man of great personal charm, he was hailed as a modernizing force in the continent despite his initial rejection of the concept of multi-party democracy. As a committed Pan-Africanist, he began the task of building a new Zambia, free to determine its own way in international affairs. But poor economic management caused its popularity to pallet, and he was voted out of office when free elections were held in 1991. Kenneth David Kaunda was born on 28 April 1924 at a mission station near the border between what was then Northern Rhodesia and Congo. His father, an ordained Church of Scotland minister, died while he was still a child, leaving the family in a straitened circumstance. Disillusioned with what he saw as the failure of his party to take a stronger line on the rights of indigenous Africans, Kaunda set up his own party, the Zambian African National Congress. Within a year, it was banned and Kaunda was back in prison.
Okay, this man told a lie at Kaunda House. He said he was just going to interview me and I'll be back.
His incarceration turned him into a radical. By 1960, he had become the leader of the new United National Independence Party and fired with enthusiasm following a visit to Martin Luther King in the US. He began his own program of civil disobedience, which involved blocking roads and burning buildings. Kaunda stood as a United Nations Independence Party candidate in 1962 elections, which saw an easy coalition with the African National Congress take power. At the time, he died aged 97.
I said I would not shave until I was told why I was in prison.